Hey everybody, Bert from Astartes Gaming here, back with what will be the 27th and most likely final episode of our Crusader Kings 2 Elder Kings mod Let's Play, specifically for this Orsinium playthrough. Crusader Kings 2 isn't going to be going anywhere, so don't worry if you're enjoying this series. However, myself and a couple of the other viewers, well, one specifically, but a few people had mentioned this before, the Orsinium playthrough is starting to stagnate a little bit, and we've been sort of stuck in the same place, or, basically taking one step forward, one step back for quite a while. And so what we're gonna do is, unless something extremely ridiculous and crazy happens in this episode, we're gonna end the Orsinium playthrough here. I will save, or, hold on to the save file just in case we ever want to come back to it, so don't worry about that. But what we'll be doing is, after this episode, we'll start a new playthrough back over in Skyrim. And I'm not sure if we're gonna start in Eastmarch, Whiterun, or maybe Solitude, but our goal is gonna be to become the High King of Skyrim. And so that's what we're gonna do in the next playthrough. And then following that one, if we either, run into a roadblock or we achieve our goal, then we're gonna move on to the continent of Akavir. And I think we're gonna take a look at the Tengmo, which are the monkey people down here. That's still open for debate, so if you guys would prefer to see a different faction, let me know. But right now, they are my top choice for the next playthrough after the Nords once again. There's also, the tiger people who are their rivals. There's a few human factions in here. However, I thought, if we were going to mix things up and go to Akavir, we would play one of the more interesting races. But that's totally up to you guys if you'd prefer to see something else. We could also play as the Khajiit or the Argonians or the Dark Elves or the Wood Elves or the High Elves if you guys would prefer. But yeah, so it's going to be one more episode of this. Then we're off to Skyrim, and from Skyrim, we'll go either take a look at the Tengmo, or whatever you guys decide instead. But yeah, so this is going to be the 27th and final episode. Just trying to make that clear. Let's go ahead and get started. So we'll get the clock running here. Somebody appointed us to be a bunch of honorary titles. Let's make sure nobody in our council is fighting any battles, except for our marshal, obviously. And we'll just kind of let the clock run and see what happens here. We really don't have. Okay, no, she's related to you, buddy. We really don't have any claims that we can take advantage of right now, with the exception of we had one on Lorient, but I think we lost it. Let's, oh, we can't. Ah, oh, man, that autosave lag kills me every time. I think my game's about to crash. Let's, disband these two armies and take a look and see if we can declare war on anybody. I was trying to get these two vassals to revolt. That's why they are their armies are raised, but that's sort of a long-term plan, and since there's only one more episode, we don't really need to play for long term. Let's take a look at short term. Okay, so we would need to declare war on. Oh, we got okay, you were a day late and a dollar short, man. But we'll take it. So he just got a claim on Mark Waston here, which we were trying to take. However, they just got re-annexed into the Kingdom of Evermore. I think we're gonna go ahead and try it. Let's see how we are on military. We've got about 1,900 troops and enough gold to call in a decent-sized mercenary army, so I'm gonna go ahead and go for it. We'll need to declare war on the King of Evermore. And we'll use our claim on Mark Weston. Okay, so let's raise our armies. And I'm not going to call in any mercenaries until we absolutely need to. It looks like we're already t pulled into a battle there, unfortunately. Let's get as many reinforcements over there as we can. And I'm going to retreat these guys back here. And I think we'll just have everybody sort of advance to shield wall and meet up there. So let's go for it. Hopefully these guys can hold out. It looks like they're going to be able to, because not only are they defending, but these guys didn't have full morale. You might need to stay there. And you guys should probably both go here and stay, because he's going to hit there in a second. Yep. Okay, there's another victory. Wait, what happened? The war just ended. Okay, so apparently one of their other wars decided to ruin my war. Let's go ahead and disband these guys and see if we can't declare war again. Hopefully we don't have a truce or something, because that's going to be really, really frustrating. I've never had that happen to me before. Okay, there we go. We lost all of our war score, but at least we can still use the claim immediately. We'll do the same thing here. We're just going to kind of congregate on Shield Wall. And then attack from there. They should be significantly weaker now that their kingdom's cut in half. So that will help us, obviously, but we still need to be careful here. Because I'm sure they do have enough money to call up some mercenaries if they need to. Actually, let's take a look and find out. Yeah, he has plenty of money to call in some mercenaries. Okay, so he called in this guy? Really? You guys are like buddies? That's not cool. Yeah. It doesn't look like they're going to be much of a threat. We won that battle. I don't know why you were there. You decided to cut through or something, I guess. Yeah, he cut through the enemy province to get to Shield Wall. Okay, so Prince Shura is of age now. He's not very good. I don't think he was our first choice for heir, though, anyways. Yeah, I think we were gonna make this guy our heir, but again, that's not gonna matter if we end the series here. Again, I'm gonna keep the save so we can come back to this, but that's gonna be entirely up to you guys if we ever come back to it. We may just keep trying different factions and leave this alone. We're just gonna go ahead and move. You can stay there. Oh. Right as he gets there. And what's taking you so long? There you go. Okay. Why isn't that showing? There we go. I think I've got a video rendering right now. I think that's why the game seems a little bit laggy, or I don't know if it's like a frame skip thing going on or what, but why won't you listen to me? There you go. Wow, they actually have a lot of defenders there. That's going to take quite a while. But they don't seem to have much else, so... I mean, if they want to try to throw these guys at me, you know, fine, but... Unless they call up a bunch of mercenaries, we should be okay. Let's see about marriage for Prince Shura here. We want somebody who's fairly young, but probably of age still. No. Let's see, we could bring her into the family. She doesn't have very good skills, though. She's better, if only slightly. So let's go ahead and call her in. I'm going to pause here. I don't really care who educates you, because you're just a distant relative. You're getting married right now, so I don't need to worry about that. Let's take the prestige. Okay. We'll unify these armies here. How we doing? Almost done. I'm hoping that'll be all the war score we need to end this. But we will see shortly, I guess. We got Zura's Crossing evermore. That is, you know... Again, if long-term concerns were a big deal right now, that would have been a huge boon for us. Oh, man. Somebody's got a claim on one of our territories. It's these guys up here. What's he going to do with it? I guess he just decided to actually take it. Excellent. Okay, we won. That was not nearly enough, apparently. So let's go to Azura's Crossing, crush their main army, and then we will siege this. Shouldn't take very long. They've only got 280 troops there. And then if need be, we'll head to Evermore. Doesn't look like Evermore's got much in the way of defenses left either. But yeah, as I was saying, the fact that they split up is actually a really big deal. Okay, we don't care. Because as it stood, they were almost as big as we were and a lot richer, and so they, you know, were basically even in terms of strength with us. Maybe a little bit weaker, but still enough to where it was kind of a concern. As it stands now, you know, they really don't have any chance against us. Whether they are, let's see, we surrender. So we get the Barony of Mark Waston. We get the prestige. Really? After only 50%? Okay, well, we'll take it. So we managed to take that. I'm gonna go ahead and return these guys home and then disband them. And I suppose we should... God, there's a lot happening in this episode. I feel kind of bad ending this series now. But still not really like enough to warrant, you know, dragging this on. What we need to do now is send him to, I don't know, maybe Garrett. We could start going east. I know I said, I think last episode we talked about going south, but with what just happened here, I think we'd be best off going here. And actually, before I do that, though, I want to make sure that I don't have any treaties with these guys. I don't think we do. Where would it show? It's probably under my tab. I keep forgetting where it shows it. Yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna just risk it. And yeah, let's go ahead and fabricate claims on Garrett there. Hopefully we can get that relatively quickly. It'd be nice if we could have that conquered as well by the end of the episode. But yeah, I don't think any amount of small little territories here is gonna change the fact that, you know, we're ending the playthrough. But as always, guys, if you want to keep going with Orsinium, let me know in the comments. But I sort of said the same thing last episode, and only one person really voiced their opinion, and they agreed with me that we should kind of move on. So again, it's entirely up to you guys, but if nobody else voices their opinion, I'm just going to go off the one voice I did here. So as always, let me know. Are you guys... Chieftain Christopher seeks to fabricate claims. Can I arrest him or something? Okay. Well, we basically got what I was hoping for long term, which was him to rebel, so that now we can basically take this and get rid of him. Okay, he's gonna get away. Let's see. He is strong enough to siege that, unfortunately. But he'll probably just run away if we start moving toward them, so I may as well just take this. Okay, so my daughter's of legal age. Let's see about a husband for her. How about... It's my cousin, no. Who are you? You're pretty good. Be great if we could win this first. And what I might do is I might go ahead and assault the holding, just so we can, you know, get it taken care of and then go after him. I don't care. It's a little bit risky going for the assault right now, because, I mean, we are taking it slightly quicker, and I don't know how many men we'll lose trying to take this. But if we lose a significant amount, we might not have enough to knock him off this spot, since this is mountainous terrain, and he is technically the defender. I think I'm gonna go for it. Yeah, we're losing a lot of men. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Okay. Oh, wow. Yeah, see? That's what I was afraid of. Now we're too weak to do anything about that. What to do here? We're gonna have to call in some mercenaries, I think, because he's just got too big of an army there now. Where he got all these guys, I don't know. He must have hired mercenaries of his own. But we're gonna have to do it too. Let's see, 90 gold for that many. What will 60 gold get me? About 1,000? That should be enough. Unfortunately, they're basically halfway across the map. Let's have them rendezvous there. Looks like he's gonna try to move back. Okay, where is he going now? He's gonna move to shield wall, it looks like. Can I ransom her? Yes, okay, we'll do that. As soon as he's out of the province, we'll go ahead and try to take it. 1,000 against 500 should be more than enough. Hopefully we can get there before he can get out. Although, we do need to be careful, because he might be able to reinforce him before we can do anything. So, let's get you here, and bait him with an attack there, and then hopefully we can keep him pinned. Mountainous terrain's probably going to be the biggest one for us. Let's see if we can't ransom this guy too. We can, okay. Very good. Okay, so we got two battles going on, both of which we have the advantage in, so we should be okay. We've won there, so we'll just leave our army there, and we should win there shortly. We'll chase them down with the mercenaries, and then once we've got them completely crushed, we'll disband the mercenaries. Hopefully he can catch them. There we go. And looks like they're just about done. They've got a couple of troops left. I'd like to get them disbanded like now, because it's costing us money every second that they're, you know, up. But that should be enough right there to finish it. 8 gold, I'm gonna have to do it. Come on. Okay. Let's pause. Let's disband you. And how have we not won this war yet? Like, they are utterly crushed. Let's just go sit on the territory then. His army's gone. His province is broken. Oh, God. Holy relic. I'm gonna risk it, because I think we might need to call in some mercenaries here, because somehow the Jarl of whatever the hell over here and in Morthal just raised a giant doom stack and marched it halfway across the map. How did they get that far? They would have had to have been like marching since well before this war started. Maybe we can get him to. No. Where? I don't understand how he got that many troops this far across the map. Like, I have no idea what's going on here. We could realistically lose this war now because I don't have any troops that can, you know, stop that. I guess we're going to need to call up some more mercenaries, and let's call up the rest of these guys as well. 12, okay, that's kind of worthless, actually. I'll just disband them. But let's look at mercenaries. I guess I can only hire for 60 gold. That's a pretty good deal. Because for 72 gold, I'd only get 100 more. So let's go ahead and hire him. And we're going to need to get him all the way over to here. You're going to need to stay where you are and maybe even retreat a little bit. Basically, the only way we're going to be able to stop this army is if we can fight them in a defensive battle in mountainous terrain. It's the only way we're going to win this, so... Rothgarion's probably going to be a good place to... Okay. They just, like, jumped right up on me, so... So much for that plan. We are decently holding our own, but it's not going to be enough. Let's go ahead and pause here. And I'm going to have to take out a loan. Let's see... Seek a loan. Where did that go? No. I clicked it and then it looked like it opened something else up, but it really didn't. Unless it's telling me I need to abandon a county claim in order to do that, but why would I want to do that? If your unwanted claim does not show up in the event, take the decision again. There's a random factor involved. I don't want to do that, though. Oh, I guess we're screwed. Oh, well, we got 3 gold there. We lost, obviously. The Queen Mother got imprisoned somehow. How do we have a disreputable nature? Okay, well, there's no way that we're going to be able to beat them with this army. So, let's try a white piece. No? Really? I mean, I've got a decent war score. Obviously, they have the advantage now, but... I don't know. Let's see. You're getting pretty close. I think I'm going to have to take a quick break and check the time, because I think we're getting awfully close. Yeah, budget deficit. Well, I tried to take out a loan. It wouldn't let me, so... I don't know what I can really do here. Kind of in a tough spot. I really don't want to have to surrender. Okay, well, that's good, but... Another defeat there. Let's let him keep wasting troops taking these. And eventually we should have enough to where we can hold them off. Damn. Of course, now that we don't have the money, you know, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. What's another 5 gold on our debt? Hmm. Okay, so we lost our army. Let's just go ahead and surrender. We don't have a choice. Actually, let's ransom a couple people first. And then, we'll go ahead and surrender. So we could use the cash at this point. I don't think it'll be enough to get us out of the deficit here. That was 10 gold. Okay. Now let's go ahead and surrender. What happens when we do that? We lose 500 prestige. Oh well. What choice do we have? I still don't have any idea how they managed to get an army. Snaglike, I name you a pretender. Chieftain Brocheal of Buelse is the true ruler of Orsinium, as recognized by myself and other nobles. Relinquish the title, there will be war. I will not be blackmailed. Okay. Let's pause really quickly, because I don't know what's happening right now. How did I lose a battle that hadn't even started yet? Huh. I don't know what happened right there. But I think this is going to be a pretty good place to end the episode, considering what just went on here. I honestly have no idea what just happened. Before I do that, I'm going to check the time and just make sure we have a full episode, so I will be right back. Okay, I'm back, and yeah, we are basically, well, yeah, actually out of time anyways, but I honestly have no idea what happened there. We had a revolt. The chief of this province here, who's like our half-brother or something, he basically revolted against us because he said he was king, and somehow in that mess, my king got kicked out of the kingdom and his son became king. And I don't know how or why that happened, but a little bit frustrating. And honestly, I don't think that's supposed to happen, because we obviously could have won that war. I mean, I'm a little bit low on troops, but we could have done it. So I'm going to go ahead and break off the episode and the series here. And I will see you guys back here for the next part of our, the first part in our next campaign in our Crusader Kings 2 Elder Kings mod Let's Play. So thanks for watching, guys.